Hello everyone, welcome to this class today, and I am going to start internal structure of the earth, how earth is structured internally and what is the impact of the things which are present inside. Okay, so from here I am beginning the class. You can see this slide. This is actually pointing the interior structure of the earth. From here you can easily observe that earth is a three layered structure. From this figure I am telling you how it is a three layered structure. This is very simple. First of all I am beginning. So this is showing the general structure of the earth. Though earth is a three layered structure, but all the three layers of the earth are again divided into sub layers. So first of all, to make you understand easily, I am showing this to you. You can see here, this is the upper part of the earth that we call lithosphere or crustal part of the earth, and below, just below this crust, this part is known as mantle, the part which is yellow, dark yellow. You can see here, this part of the earth is known as mantle, and the interior part, the central part of the earth, is called as core. So from this picture you can easily understand earth is a three layered structure. The uppermost structure is known as crust, the upper part is crust, intermediate part is known as mantle, and the central part of the earth is known as core, right. Now point that I am going to tell you is that this is central part of the earth, and from here distance up to this upper part, up to the surface, is 6371 kilometers, and it is very difficult for anyone to enter towards the core of the surface, up to the core of the surface. So the question is, how do we get information about the internal structure of the earth? The point is, the internal structure of the earth is known, or information about the earth's interior is basically based on the study of seismic waves. It is based on the study of seismic waves. Now what are seismic waves? Seismic waves are waves generally which are produced during the occurrence of an earthquake. There are different type of seismic waves, like P wave, S wave, L wave, and these all waves have their different properties. But out of these waves, all these waves, the P waves are the only waves that travel throughout the earth, that means from this upper surface up to the core of the earth, and then these are also observed to opposite part of that, towards the antipodal point of the earth. That means complete information about the earth's interior can be obtained based on the path which is followed by the primary waves or P wave, that is a kind of seismic wave which generates during the occurrence of an earthquake. So this is a general point that you have to know to study about the earth's interior. Not taking much time, directly I will come to the structure of the earth's interior. So if earth is divided into number of parts or number of layers, this would be the division of layers of the earth's interior. First of all, the earth is broadly divided into three layers. I have already mentioned you, upper part is crust, intermediate part is mantle, and the central part is known as core. Now this crustal part is again divided into two categories. The crust can be divided into, this crust can be divided into upper crust and lower crust. mental can be divided into, here you can see, mental can be divided into upper mental, I'm writing here, mental can be divided into upper mental and lower mental. Likewise, this core, this can again be divided into outer core and inner core. That means if this upper part is known as crust, this is divided into upper crust and lower crust. If this second part is known as mantle, mantle can again be divided into upper mantle and lower mantle. Likewise, the core is again divided into two sublayers, upper core and inner core or lower core, outer core and inner core. This would be the inner core. Same, the things that I have told you here is shown here. You can see easily point out that this upper part is crust. And after that, these two are denoting the second layer, that is known as mantle. So this is upper mantle. Don't worry, I would be telling you depth of these layers, properties of these layers separately, but first of all you have to know the structure of these layers, division of these layers. Then after understanding this, you can easily understand their depth, their properties and all that. Then this layer, now see, this layer is known as outer core and this is inner core, which is central part of the earth. So generally this is the structure of the earth, the three layers again divided into two sub layers. The upper part is crust and the upper crust is the layer where generally we live, where human beings, animals, ecosystem, all biomes, all these survive. So this upper crust is also known as lithosphere, where all the human being, animals and etc. are present. Now from this we'll move towards the division, the things that you can write in exams. So we'll move towards the divisions, how earth is divided and how we can understand the structure of the earth. Okay, now coming to this, you can see from this image, if a section of the earth is removed and put like this, after this you can, after watching this, after studying this, you can easily understand the interior structure of the earth. This is demarcating the layers of the earth. Now, as I have already mentioned, there are three layers and those three layers are again divided into two sub layers. So here you can see this part, I have enlarged this image. Okay, this part is the central solid part of the earth, that is known as core of the earth. Now this part, this is core of the earth, this is core of the earth, you can see. And in this core part, this is the solid, this is the liquid. All these layers are solid. Now I would be telling you this very easily that you can understand, right? Okay, so the upper part of the earth, that is crust, you can see this part of the earth, this is known as crustal part of the earth, where all the mountains, plains, plateaus, oceans, etc. are present. This upper crustal part is very thin. I have already shown you this in the image. This part is known as crust, which is very thin. In the textbooks you will find that depth of the crust is between, so I am writing here that you can note down, the properties of upper crust. Depth of upper crust is between 0 to 20 kilometers. This is the depth of upper crust. That means this upper part, upper crust is between 0 to 20 kilometers. And basically it is formed of granite rocks. There are number of rocks, but major part of the upper crust is formed of granite rocks. Density of granite rocks is around 2.7 gram per centimeter cube, and this is the property of this upper crust. Below that is lower crust. Lower crust is generally found between 20 to 70 kilometers. It is said that it is present between 20 to 70 kilometers, formed of basaltic material, and the density is 3 gram per centimeter cube. So when I would be telling you properties of the Earth's interior, generally density from the crust towards the core increases. Density of core is around 13 gram per centimeter cube. Here it is 2.7. So density and temperature both increases from this upper part towards the central core part. Okay. Now after this starts the mantle. After this starts the mantle, and mantle is said to be present up to 2900 kilometers. Mantle is present up to 2900 kilometers, and this mantle, I have already mentioned that mantle is divided into upper mantle and lower mantle. Upper mantle, which is very important, this part, upper mantle is very much important. This is indicating the division of upper mantle, because when it starts from 70 kilometers, after that from 100 kilometers to 200 kilometers, it has semi-liquid material, which is molten material or magma, and the magma is generally the region from where volcanic material erupts out towards the surface. This region between 100 to 200 kilometer is known as asthenosphere. This is known as asthenosphere, right? So if someone asks you which layer is the most important layer inside the earth, first answer that you should know, that you should reply, is the asthenosphere, because all the tectonic activities, all the volcanic activities, most of the seismic activities, they are somehow related with the asthenosphere, which is part of upper mantle, right? Upper mantle is between 70 kilometers up to 700 kilometers. Friends, that you should remember, you should always keep this in mind. That means if I divide here, upper mantle is divided again into three parts. Just a second. Upper mantle is divided into again into three parts. Upper mantle is divided into three parts. I am writing here upper mantle, and what are the three parts? 70 to 100 kilometers, that is solid part. Between 70 to 100, it is solid. Just a second. Okay. So between upper mantle, between 70 to 100 kilometer, this is solid. After 100 to 200, then it is semi-liquid, that is known as asthenosphere. And then after asthenosphere, it is again solid. It is again solid. That means this lower part, this part, lower part of the upper crust is again solid. So that means after 200 kilometer up to 700 kilometer, it is again solid. Then after this solid part, starts the lower mantle, starts the lower mantle. Lower mantle is again solid, but density increases towards the end, towards the central part of the earth. Then after this 2900 kilometer, when mantle is over, when mantle ends, starts the outer core. Outer core is the layer that is perceived up to 5150 kilometer, and this is the layer which is in liquid state. So friends, now you have a question, students, why this layer is liquid but inner core is solid? You should read this, you should study this, you should try to find answer and tell me. Okay, now this layer, coming to this 5150, after 5150 kilometer, the inner core, that is up to 6371 kilometers, is the most solid layer of the earth. So now from here you can easily understand that these layers are divided into, first of all, three layers, then three layers are again divided into two sub layers, but out of these sub layers, upper mantle is the layer that has important layer called asthenosphere between 100 to 200 kilometer, that is semi-liquid layer, that is semi-liquid layer where molten material is filled. I would end this video after telling you about the transitional zones, which are called as discontinuities. So discontinuities, generally discontinuities are asked in exam. Actually, after one layer there is a transition of around 2 to 4 kilometers, from where physical and chemical properties of the earth's interior starts to change, and these transitional layers are known as discontinuities. There are number of discontinuities that are found inside the earth after every layer. So I will end this video after showing you these discontinuities. Here you can see this in detail. This is the detailed structure of earth's interior, and this is the, these are the discontinuities that are found. So coronal discontinuity is found between upper crust and lower crust. That means when properties of upper crust starts to change and lower crust start, the area, the this part, this transitional part, just a second. Okay, this part here is the discontinuity is known as coronard. After that, between crust and mantle, the discontinuity is mohorovic. Between upper mantle and lower mantle, the discontinuity is repetitive discontinuity, and between the mantle and core, the discontinuity is Wishart and Gutenberg discontinuity. Lehmann is the last discontinuity which is found between the inner core and outer core. So with this I am ending the video. I hope you, now you have information, you have a thorough understanding about the interior structure of the earth. Thank you so much for being with me today.